nice to see the 3D version of all of you instead of having you just on flat screen on Zoom. Mark, I can't thank you enough for that warm introduction, and I have truly always valued your friendship and your insights. And I'm particularly grateful because it's Mark's earnings week, and he's here tonight, so thank you for that. Lori, I want to say thank you to the Committee for Economic Development and the Conference Board for recognizing me for this award. I also want to take a moment to congratulate my fellow honorees, Brian, John, Judy, Margaret, and Nubar. Congratulations. And I am so honored to be part of this distinguished group. For years, the CED has convened the best thinking and leadership across businesses and policy to tackle the most urgent and challenging issues facing our nation. They've demonstrated the proven track record of nonpartisan public-private partnerships and have consistently championed collaboration, equity, and opportunity, qualities that CVS Health prioritizes in everything that we do. And so I'm very honored, Lori, to accept this Distinguished Leadership Award on behalf of my 300,000 colleagues, many who have been on the front lines every day from the pandemic from the very beginning, and reflect this year's theme of leadership in challenging times. It truly has been a unique and challenging experience leading CVS Health during the pandemic, a time when America needed us most. And that's one I feel very privileged and honored to have. And I have to thank and take this opportunity to thank the countless heroes, some of you are here today, from across the country, from doctors and nurses to the scientists who were developing the vaccine, to the truck drivers and the community organizations who frankly all continue to be so selfless in their commitment to taking care of others. As Mark noted in his introduction, our colleagues met and continue to meet in this unprecedented moment in our country. And this award is actually their award, a testament to their innovative thinking, their resilience, and their dedication to the millions of Americans that we are very privileged to serve. Like the CED, CVS Health believes everyone deserves quality access to affordable health care that is simple and affordable. Guided by our purpose to bring our heart to every moment of your health, we're pivoting to offer more personalized solutions to meet people where they are, in the community and virtually. So much of health is determined by our local environment. Things like access to secure housing, healthy food, and good-paying jobs. This is why we always have to think local, listening, learning, and collaborating to better understand the services and solutions communities need most. Reimagining the healthcare system in this country requires us to simplify, to break down barriers in a system that can be confounding and complex. Putting the customer in the center of everything that we do is extremely important to us. While I'm proud of what we've been able to accomplish, we have so much more work to do. I want to talk a moment about a critical area of focus, which, as Mark noted, I am extremely passionate about. We are aggressively addressing the mental health crisis in this country. One of the crushing collateral damages of this pandemic. According to a recent study by the Kaiser Foundation, currently 4 in 10 adults report symptoms of anxiety and depressive disorder. That's 4 times what was noted in 2019. And I'm sad to tell you that suicide is the 10th leading cause of death in America. I believe it's imperative for the public and private sectors to step up and work together to create solutions before this crisis gets worse. And I'd like to take a moment to thank my husband, who is here this evening, for his efforts to normalize the conversation around mental health. But more importantly, I thank him for his unwavering support for everything that I do. These are times of great consequences. Our communities are depending on all of us to meet this critical moment. And progress requires partnership. Partnerships with community-based organizations, health systems, providers, and the broader business community. And so I want to close by thanking all of the distinguished leaders in this room and those that are watching virtually for boldly advancing ideas and initiatives to move our country and our economy forward with purpose and with impact. Thank you to the CED for this award, but more importantly, congratulations to the rest of tonight's honorees for their extraordinary and deserving accomplishments. Thank you.
Karen, thank you so much, and congratulations.